I know it.
Yeah.
My guess is that he plays long.
Oh, right. Okay. So Matt knows this player really well. He's actually Canadian as well. So we've got a...
We like to play out long. That's where the Canadian geese and moose often pass by. So, you know, we like to sightsee.
Yeah, whatever that means. And it looks like, are we getting into this one? I think we are. Hit it
what
on the big
this
screen.
Pistol round? LG. They've four got... players outside the mid doors already. Yeah, looking said... like they want to get aggressive. That smoke out on Xbox. Good shot from Fur.
Yeah, really aggressive stuff. This is very unorthodox. You said we might see some cool stuff here, but I don't think I've ever seen anything like this. This is kind of nuts. No one towards long, no one short. Four players towards middle. Very aggressive, of course. Fur just facing from lower B, looking to find the next headshot. They have killed DSR. And now just trying to reposition themselves. That smoke they put onto Xbox, pretty much redundant now. They have got one more, and now they'll be making their way towards T-Spawn. But Fur, just relentless right now. Has done a lot of damage onto Buzzer, but he's coming to life. Dust2 is his map. He gets the kill, equals things out, and now Buzzer, what are you made of, my man? Gets taken down.
Get
this
right.
Is going to be brutal now. Cold Zera is doing some absolute work
Cold Zera!
What was that? That second and third shot were out of this world. Okay, calm down.
Cold, you are a madman, and you are banned. This was one of his best maps. Individually, this was one of Cold Zero's best maps when they used to play.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like the talent they've got would suggest that they can have a lot of aggression here. They can be falling around. It'd be a perfect map for them if they were to play a little bit more. So like we said, this is a chance for them against these lower teams to kind of get a little bit more comfortable on it. But as I said, though, two frags coming in for the terrorists. Fur replies with the HE kill, but...
I like it.
Yeah, they have taken a ton of damage here. DSR on low. That same story for Taco here. You can see him...
And he's thinking about pushing. This is audacious, considering the situation with his HP. He wants the information, but he's found by Buzzer! Woo! Buzzer!
4-1 now. That's it. The aggression from Luminosity is punished. And it's going to be, without a roof, surely taking round number two here. Coldzera has got the M4. And we saw what he did on the pistol, but I feel like this may be a reach too far. Let's see what he does do. We've got a roof for tons of time here. Don't want to rush into any unfavorable situations. Going to be holding up outside the long doors. Dissecting the map here as they drop the bomb outside that area as well. I feel like this could take a while. They want to make sure they clear out everything here. Can justify sacrificing the man. That'll be the first one. DSR does go down where they find out where Coldzera is. The bomb now presumably picked up. And the signal was called to get towards B. One player holds the mid doors. I'll be A, but he's low HP. This could fall apart, Matt. It's not set in stone just yet how this one goes down.
Well.
Oh, God.
They're this not- is definitely an interesting strategy. Cold's here. Outside the door, drawing his gun and Buzzer. He's got the clutch. He's got two kills. Told you he was going to be better here.
Yeah, I agree. But you saw that reload coming in from Cold. Had that have been a different time. Potentially could have got that first kill. It could have been a horrible, horrible outcome, but they managed to survive. Without a roof, the force buy in the second works out for them. We go to round number three. Of course, Luminosity force buying back themselves. Two scouts, and they've got some CZs and a P250 as well. Head armor to boot, so could be interesting, eh? No real aggression coming from the terrorists just yet. A lovely default, just working out whether there is any intel to be found. They do sort of fur towards short as well, so FNX on the screen right now. Trying to do some damage here with the CZ. Not going to amount to anything just yet. And at this point, without a roof, just want to hold up. Run the time down, bleed out the CTs, force them to make the next move, maybe the first mistake, get a pick, and then they can stay together and just execute onto the site. That's what you should be doing. We have seen many teams in the past. I remember the last one I remember going crazy at was Envious, watching Apex run through the mid-doors for no reason. That comes to mind for some reason. That was giving me nightmares recently.
Nightmares for you. I had some weird dreams last night.
Okay.
I don't know if we want to get into them.
As long as they...
I don't know, something about driving a 16-valve 1992 GTI and putting it into a river and then driving it out of the river and then, I don't know, it was all messed up. But God bless that Mark I 16-valve.
Sounds like a... Okay, wait a second.
It was a real gem.
That's not even...
FNX pulls the magazine out of the gun and then puts it back into the handle where his hand is because that's how Counter-Strike CZs work. Fallen gonna watch the off angle. Taco inside of the B site has this boosted position.
Ooh.
Cold, okay, Fallen. Do what you want with the scout. I don't care anymore. You are a god.
God, Fallen confirmed. Now the terrorists will be committing around the clock right down here. Another headshot from Fallen. This time it's through the wall. The bomb has been dropped. FNX could have been baited in here for the CZ spray down. Finally, though, we've had a roof do come back into this one. 3-1 in their favor. It did look very hairy for a second. but they managed to get hold of the situation, fallen, lighting them up there like birthday candles.
That was absolutely sick.
Yeah.
That jump shot, get wrecked.
Well, the force by from the Brazilians does not work out, but like I said, without a roof going for a heavy default at the start, and then forcing their way towards short, lost a couple of kills, bomb dropped as well. All it took was one more CZ kill. That could have been an absolute nightmare, but now they know they're secure. It's a full EK from Luminosity. And maybe we do have something to work with here on Dust2. Maybe.
It's possible.
Not much, but something.
Well, Taco's going to hold. Covers the angle. Does get dinked up a significant amount of times, in fact.
A ton of damage there. Actually gets a kill as well. That's crazy with the USP.
Oh, look at Cole. Look at how much, like, is this like a lack of respect? Is this just like, nah, I don't care, I'm going through the smoke. Like, what? Doesn't even wait for the rotations, just tries to take the fight.
He headshot another one, but this round should be secure at this point. Seb has been dinked as well. Tons of damage coming in. And he'll be finding that kill on towards Fur. Just Fallen remaining now. P2000 in hand. Round over. Final kill coming in. Come on, boys, let's get it. 3-1. We've had a roof bouncing back here. Round number four going in their favour. So the money now stabilising for Luminosity. Things probably will get a lot more interesting once Fallen gets the orb, which he has now. Still is a difficult buy here for the CTs.
So sexy when Fallen ups.
Very sexy. You're having different kind of dreams about that as well, I'd imagine.
Yeah. yes, Henry.
Obviously.
I was.
Well then, three players towards the B tunnels for the terrorist side, but FNX aggressive, of course. Punished, though. DSR reads it. He gets the first kill, and now they don't need to commit here. They don't need to walk in towards B. I'm not sure why you would force the issue here at this point. CTs have the ones that have to react, and they're given an opportunity to find some kills here. But it is going to be Seb locking things down there. The Cold's error of two gets Luminosity back into the round. 3-on-3. No one does find the kill as well finally, though. So now the terrorists have a heavy advantage. Like I said, the lack of utility or defuse kits having the CTs and falling without armor as well. Buzzer, what a position. He knows exactly what's going on. Bomb yet to be planted.
Buzz, just watching the doors. A very good position for him to play.
He's timing it perfectly as well. He's going to get that call to Fallen any day of the week. There it is. He's been the MVP so far, bouncing back. This is what it takes from a top player, not getting phased by a bad performance. Man, he gets the double as well. So this is actually getting kind of interesting. I think we have a game on our hands.
I think we do as well. Without a roof, looking super solid so far. And encouraging signs in the way that they're playing this map. Buzza again holding off on middle. He's got six kills. He does top frag. Along with Ape, who again had another solid performance in the last game.
So as we were saying before, this is a map that's normally the go-to veto for Luminosity. They're trying it out in this tournament. We want to see if they can show they are comfortable on it. But so far, against a team like this and considering the circumstance, it's running away from them a little bit here. But still early days. Taco finds the Desert Eagle headshot. He takes down no one, but Ape with full on control.
He took down someone.
Come on. We've done that. We've explored that.
Oh, you're right. I'm sorry. We do explore a lot of things, you and I, Henry G.
5-4, and they have got full on control. This port, that's a very decent flash from the CT territory. Surely a frag, but Buzzer, he's too strong on Dust2. He takes down Fur. Cold Zero coming in with a refrag, though. Seb finds one in the B tunnels. 3-on-3 should heavily favour the terrorists here, but FNX with the Desert Eagle looking to do some serious work here. Bomb will be planted on A, though. CTs are gathering weapons at this point, considering the money. They've got three AKs. Actually, now it's actually quite a viable situation. I was going to say maybe to save these, but considering the amount of advantage they have and the bomb just being planted, still something to work with here. Oh my god, what a shot from FNX.
Dude, what okay. Is that? Cold Zero's picked up another.
Absolutely wrecked.
That was just insane. Insanity. I mean, the good news is for Buzza, you did say it was the pug map. He's looking a lot more solid, but that retake from not only the shot from FNX, but from Luminosity showing off. They're ready to play. They want to win this just as much as any team. But like you say, a game on our hands. They now have reset potential, oddly enough, against them. And the money's actually decent for the terrorist side.
Yeah, with 8.7K, I feel like they'll be fine. You can see no one has 8 as well. So the reset should be avoided ultimately. They've gone for a double orb, though, on the T side. That's going to cost them going forward. We'll see whether it's going to be problematic for the CTs here. They've gone for the single orb setup, of course. Fallen probably counts about 3 NA orbers, to be fair. So we'll see what he can bring to the table. Going to round number 7. Three players towards long for the CTs. Going to be settling up there waiting for the rush. Nothing coming in just yet, so he'll be more than happy to leave Fur in that position. Lewis in a very default stance. We have got Buzzer though. Look at the confidence he's got now, Matt. This is a different player than what we saw in the first map. He's ready. Going into key choke points, facing them, smoking them out, taking the vision away from the CTs, takes heavy nade damage, but that's not phasing him right now.
And FNX is going to try and play on the edge of this smoke spot when Buzzer walks through. Buzzer seems to be aware of this. He has a good read.
He's going
to
get this kill, I know it.
Oh, you would have thought it.
He got it anyway, I told you.
Anyway. There it is.
I knew it.
All right, Henry.
He knew it.
The prediction game on point. Buzzer playing sick. Cold Zera. Trying to cover off outside of those B doors, though. Fur's got great position. Going to go for this flank play. Problem is that he needs to get an early read on this, and thankfully they haven't gone either direction because he has a guy still on catwalk. Bomb goes down, falls away. Smart play because now he can sit back there and just be a pest. As Ape walks through middle and Cold does decent damage to start things off. He goes down to 73.
Yeah, AWP on Ape instead of the AK. They have got the bomb in position as well. They do pick it up. 25 seconds, this round should be over unless they can do some serious work with this AWP, but you've got Fallen waiting for you. That's the first shot, headshot of course. And Seth now just praying he can get onto the site undetected. So far he actually has done that. Just trying to get a courtesy bomb plant down here to get an extra $800 for the team. It will be planted actually, so pretty much all he could have hoped for. He can get a little frag as well, maybe that'll be interesting. Gets Taco, so considering the circumstance map, that wasn't too bad for him. Bomb planted, it means they're going to boost the coffers going into the next one, but Luminosity now begin to the swing of things. They've got the double orbs now as well. Without a roof, should be able to buy with that plant. I saw them have a ton of cash around before. Let's see what they have going for this one. So yeah, it's not the best buy, of course, but no one could drop a Galil and then they can balance the books that way. But looks like they may not be doing that. Deagle on Ape. What's the plan here, boys?
AWP on DSR. I'd say the plan is to buy as much as possible.
Okay, well.
Double op setup, Cold Zero and Fallen. And Fallen,
why, okay, so Ape's got an AK. Why is he buying a Deagle then?
Because,
communication game,
Deagle,
definitely
bro.
Not on point, I have to say.
Because Deagle, bro.
That's what I'm looking at. That's what confused
me. I mean, they're
me so
fully
much.
Invested anyway, so.
You know, that's what I mean, but like
I know
$700.
I know,
like, every dollar counts against a team like this. Like, if you've got to work out how you're going to buy, don't buy the Deagle before you've actually worked out what you're doing.
Maybe he gets a sick one tap with the Deagle, switches to the AK, and kills the other four.
All right, okay. We'll
see. And then that. You will eat your words.
And then?
And then?
We never did that, did we?
And then? And then, and then, and then, and then, and then. All right.
No, and then. Fallen takes down Ape, of course. DSR now on the AWP, smoked out.
Glass cannon as well, has to be careful not to get sprayed down through those doors.
Ooh, what?
Okay.
Why not?
Get wrecked, Fur.
Just when they needed a miracle, DSR delivers. But Buzzer and no one on very low HP indeed. You can see DSR has the only smoke, he needs to do some more work here. He did find that first kill, but Fallen does get a little bit of intel here, but it's not going to be the right area. The terrorists are looking to set themselves up for the B split. We have got our boy Buzzer still alive. You know what that means.
It means the clutch is going to happen.
Okay, well, we'll see whether the...
Because I believe in a thing called love.
30 seconds. Terrorists now making their move to B, but it's a perfect flashbang. Good. Oh, it's a collateral. Okay. Game over, round over.
That doesn't help at all. Cold Zero, Seb still inside middle. Those going to try and segregate them, but Fallen still there. He didn't expect to, and Cold Zero closes it off. The AWPs, the two AWPs, all five kills.
Yeah, Cold Zero and Fallen, not a pretty combo, you have to say.
You're not a pretty combo.
Well, I'm your combo, so. But you're
That's
flaming,
true.
You're flaming
I'm
yourself.
Probably the one that brings us down.
4-4 now. Oh, help and options. What help and options can we offer towards Without a Roof right now? Not many, because they actually have Desert Eagles and PT-50s, so not really much to do there. Fallen gets the kill on Seb as he was just crossing T-spawn, Matt. He just wanted to get to the other side of the map.
Why did the chicken cross the road, Henry? Because someone pressed E on it, and now they follow you.
That's true. Relevant. Good way to get that in there.
Isn't that amazing?
That's an Easter egg, which is funny because they've got a little Easter hats on as well.
That's true. That is true. That is true.
So there you go.
Apparently now you can shoot them in the head as well, and they run around like chickens with their head cut off, finally. As Fur, going to let this time expire, take down the last remaining player. And now it's pretty straightforward. 5-4 for Luminosity over Without a Roof. Who did have a better start? I have to say, a much better start.
Yeah, they didn't even win the pistol this time. They bounced back. They got themselves in a decent position here. So Without a Roof going to round number 10. They have got the AWP, not the double this time. 4 AKs to join Ape. And it's been pretty inconsistent. We've seen DSR on the orb, we've seen Ape on it. There's definitely see this a little bit of a pug style going into it, but this time, faster approach. Xbox smoke goes down, taking away the vision from the CTs. Go together. Maybe smoke up towards the catwalk and drop down, but it's heavy nade damage coming in. And it's going to be Molotov there as well to slow them down. So that's the fast approach taken out. And the CT's probably heard the footsteps there as well. So Old Zero set up an occasion B angle towards that car. And the CT's now, we'll see what the next move is, because you can see a lack of utility. They've got smokes and Molotovs to be fair, but there's not really much to do. They'd have to have a full execution here to take away the AWPer. Smoke up, flashbangs over, two players drop down the spawn, one fires the face and push him back. I just don't feel like they have that. Here we go then, here's the execution, Matt. Are you ready?
I am ready.
Horrible.
Well, Cold Zero with one can fall back now to play the long position. He has FNX up close still. Inside that goose with the rifle, pops out late, another kill for him. Ape goes down, Seb's managed to drop, but the smoke, terribly placed in the corner, favors Cold Zero.
It's horrible, it's disgusting. Stick to the pug style, guys. Do not try new set pieces when you haven't got your own game leader or your actual full lineup.
Somewhere.
So like away. I said, that it was the right idea. You have to do, so the way you do that, might do a smoke CT spawn, you do a smoke on catwalk, you drop. Flash over and you drop, and you have to keep the flashes pumping over while they get to the corner. You are flashing your teammates, but the time they get to the corner, you've actually got position on the ramp and you can actually stifle the CTs onto the bomb site. But if you have one player jumping out before even the flash goes off, and the AWP can just watch him and almost laugh at him, it's not really going to work out too well. So another force buy here for the terrorists. This game is slipping away from them now. Cold Zero, another lovely shot from him. It's going to be two frags going in their favour, so this is actually getting a little bit brutal. 5-on-3 now. We have got two AKs on 8 and Seb. No one on the Deagle, but round over, my friend. Coming in there through the door. Find a kill. Actually, they find two, so maybe there's still something to work with here, but the remaining HP of the terrorists suggest otherwise.
Well, that's a decent jump in through. So that's one of the coolest smokes on the B site, in my opinion. You bounce it off the edge of the tunnels. It covers off the back of the site and allows you to jump up or check closet. And Seb goes for the jump up. It catches them off guard. Unfortunately, they can't follow it up, and therefore the bomb is dropped inside of the site. No one's going to try and come from window late. FNX not facing, and it's Fur that walks out and catches him entirely off guard. Perfect timing. Could have been something out of that, though, for Without a Roof, who have now lost 6 in a row.
Well, they do get maximum loss bonus. For anyone not familiar with the system, it means after losing 5 rounds in a row, you do get $3,400. And as soon as you win a round, that is reset back to $1,400. That's going to help without a roof, I should say. It's quite a mouthful. So I think we should say Wargaming. We'll be getting 4 AKs and Desert Eagle here. No utility whatsoever. First kill coming from Fallen. He takes down Ape. Electro coming to the buzzer as well. This is just full on Pug strats now. Use the spawns and dust too. Hope for the best. And it's not working out too well, I have to say. Very quick round there. Well, it's over before I even explain the economy system of CS.
Don't worry about it. The economy in CS isn't important, Henry.
I'm going to have a sip of my coffee, so when you say something interesting.
Something interesting. That's a... Don't have Google with me this time. I'm sorry. I can't fake it.
It's funny. Someone said that to me last night. Anyway, we go into round number 13.
That's unfortunate, Henry. I know you've been waiting a long time.
Ape does get the first kill. He takes down FNX, and that's actually a very good start here. So they actually went for that long spawn and get the first frag, so maybe something to work with here. Long, one of the most valuable parts of the map to have control of. It means the CTs have to react. They need to be pushing short, pushing B tunnels. You can see now Furlick for the next frag. Easy. Takes down Ape and gets the double as well.
Did you get that one in there?
Yeah, I did. And it's going to be 4-on-3 now. As soon as it began from Without a Roof, it slips away from them. It's going to be stepping up massively there. Gets out a short push. Finds two frags, and once again, it's looking like a round heavily favoring the Brazilians.
It is going to be Taco waiting on the other side of the smoke at mid. DSR drops down. He'll have heard that, Taco. So he changes his angle slightly, gets a little bit closer in right now toward that doorway, but unfortunately he goes down. Cold Zero rotating back inside of the site, has to fall away, jumps up with a knife out, gets the information, goes to the op, and misses the shot. No one comes in closer, and now they have the B site to work with.
Surely this is the round. Without a Roof now, 3 players on the B site, but Fallen! No one's going to step up. It looked like a shot Fallen was going to hit, but let's get beaten to the punch depth. So there it is. As I mentioned before, that's the loss bonus reset now. So if they lose the next round, they only get $1,400. Luckily for them, keeping 3 players alive does help things considerably. You can see Seb does have around $4,000 after the reinvestment of the grenades. Able to be dropped a weapon, so they are pretty decent stead here. And double orbs, once again, interesting. It's quite an orthodox tool a terrorist team to do. We did see it quite a lot towards the end of 2015. Not being used so much at the moment, but for a very aggressive orbital, but actually a rare miss from him. Does rectify his aim, takes down Buzzer. In my opinion, the MVP so far of Tusk 2. There's going to be no one taking down Cold Zara. So they have got skill, this team, from Ladder Roof. You can see they have got frag potential here, and it is coming in a lot more effectively on Tusk 2. A 3-on-3, once again getting control of that B side. Bomb waiting to cross with a close range of the AWP. DSR with nice positioning here, though. Could do the existing style drop down to CD spawn when assessed his teammates are on the B side.
Flash in, though, from Fur, who desperately wants back into this B site. Has managed to utilize the smoke, get toward the car. That'll pull the aim away, but no one's able to snap back to window in time to take down FNX. Meanwhile, lurking in middle, Fallen takes down DSR. It's suddenly just on him. Against two, bomb not planted, they throw it across. They have no idea of Fallen's position right now.
Well, they would have had death cam. They would have seen he went towards the lower B tunnels, which I thought was why Fallen would come back towards mid doors. But he's sticking to this, he's committing.
It's all right, Ape's not going to be faced. Oh, that's going to give it away.
No, this is okay, he's used a smoke there to kind of take away the vision. That actually eradicates the orb. Ape.
That's scary. You know the no scope's going to come, but when he gets around.
Oh, it's on his head!
Oh, how does he not fix? So there is a little clipping on the box right there where you can stand on.
But it wasn't high enough.
I don't think he would have known.
Yeah, he was actually on his head. That's kind of funny. But there it is. Vadaroo for two rounds in a row. We're going to round number 15. We must have won the half, but War have put up a much more convincing case for themselves.
Absolutely. And I take back what I said about, I mean, there's a little bit of questionable plays that came out from Luminosity early on in this game that allowed Without a Roof to get a start, but I mean, I would have expected way better than this from Luminosity. So Without a Roof looking much more coordinated here. They've got a double op setup to run this time. DSR and Ape.
To be fair, Without a Roof are finding the opening frags pretty easy. It's when someone else has to step up massively for Luminosity to get them back into it. It feels like as well, a lot of clutches.
This is, okay, I don't agree with this. You're running a double, that's stupid. You're running a double op setup. You give your op, let him pull out a Tech 9 and walk into a site through a smoke.
Yeah,
for no reason.
I'm not even sure if you get through undetected. What's your move then? You can't even have. You don't have the rifle to actually kill anyone on the bomb site. You kind of.
That's just giving yourself away.
Yeah, that's very silly. All right. Flashbang. Not gonna work though. FNX gets taken out by Ape, holding the angle, waiting for the aggressive push. CTs are way too aggressive here. Once they have that man advances as well, they don't need to be facing angle. That's considered one of the most deadliest angle for a CT in the game. Facing towards shore, facing towards middle. The terrorists are going to be there most times. And Buzzer now coming to life, finds a kill on towards Fur. 3-on-3 once again. These clutches have been going in the favor of the terrorists. That's not going to help, though. And it is going to be man advantage in favor of LG.
Taco's going to watch the cross. Late smoke. Seb jumps over. He's got the information they've committed. And now the rest of the arsenal will rotate. Taco outside of the window. Flash in. Fallen finds no one. The start of it could try and return the damage onto Seb, but that allows Cold Zero to walk in undetected, and it will go 9-6 for Luminosity.
Yeah, you said
but
that.
A much, much, much better half.
Wasn't exactly convincing. It's not like we said, oh, wow, they've obviously been working on this map. They look incredibly strong. But in the same token, they know they're going against pretty much full mix here, so maybe they're just having fun. I don't know. It would be hard to say. Fallen was tweeting before this game saying, yes, it is Dust 2. He had a funny picture of SpongeBob SquarePants, so maybe he's just saying, yeah, we're just having a good time.
We're having a good time, having a good time.
Don't stop falling.
Keep going.
No, my voice it's
my voice is wrecked.
Yeah, my voice. I can feel my throat getting very sore. I feel like tomorrow will be.
It might be strep throat, and I may have infected everyone. Don't worry.
Perfect.
Well, I have a stockpile of penicillin. You guys are all gonna die.
Where do I get penicillin from? How do I get that?
The doctor.
I'm not allowed to go there anymore.
I've seen you too many times, I've given you too many lectures, and you can get out of my office.
You never learn your lesson. Get out of here. Right then, second half. Luminosity on the T side. This is where we'll see where the work's been done. This is where the homework can come into fruition. CT towards long. They have gone for four sets of armor and one HE on no one, and a fuse kit as well. So he's gone aggressive after DSR facing here. This is audacious. Does have an exit strategy, but he has. He is playing with fire right now. Not a good card.
DSR is just going to wait. Now, has he heard them running from this? Because they might, with Taco left here, that might encourage DSR to push through long, and Taco's going to be waiting for that.
Indeed. Well, we have got luminosity. Four players on short, one towards long. CTs with just the USPs here. They don't have the smokes locking them out. So when the next move comes in, Fallen does have the flashbang. Could be difficult for them to actually hold it off. There's the flash. Here comes the play. That takes the vision away from Seb, but just long enough for them to actually get on the side. That H is actually really interesting. That actually takes the vision away from the bomb side as well, as doing damage. But FNX does find two kills with the Glock. We assume Taco won't actually get that one. So round should be secured.
That was well played by FNX, though. He wrapped all the way back around before they even had the bomb site. He was on the back.
The point
of them.
I was making about that HQ as well. Actually, I'll let it play out. It looks like it's getting
interesting. Yeah, you should, because Abe's going to play it out. Abe's got two now as he walks closer. Good response from Fallen. Has to find another, and it's Fur. I know exactly where you're going with that. It's similar to the doors almost.
Yes.
Mid.
So the fact that he actually clears out the site in terms of if anyone does a ton of damage, but the smoke lasts like 3 or 4 seconds on the HE. When they're doing that, they're crossing the site, and that smoke's there, actually takes away any vision from the CTs and gives them enough time to have a more advantageous angle as well. I'm not sure that was the full intention, but it worked out that way. It'll be interesting to find out whether that's what they were going for. I'd have to look at the demo, see the timing. But let's see how this one goes down. Another two, it's going to be without a roof. Force buying in the second. Two scouts can be very effective indeed, or Dust 2. Probably one of the best maps next to Cash for this weapon. And we'll see how this one pans out. But walking the B side, finds no one. By himself, of course. That's going to force the CTs to start reacting. No towards long, it's going to be back there, finding two very easy frags there with the MP7. Round over. I would say save the scouts, but you're going to do very well. Same as one of these being given away.
Oh, that was about as sexy as my third flick on you, Henry. DSR gets taken down by
Is there a YouTube bot of that, by the way?
There is, actually, yeah. I watched it.
I want to see the reckoning.
Yeah, you should. It's a good time, good
luck. I like that there was so much hype going into that game.
Even the interviews were like, the funny thing is, I was like, I'm going to tilt him. I didn't do any. Every time I killed you, I should have literally gotten down and done a push-up and been like, get wrecked, get wrecked.
But it was like,
wrecked.
It was all like, everyone was like, oh, what could happen? Then when it got to 9-0, it's like, it was quiet in the room. And they gave you like the golf clap and you got the first kill.
It was so good, wasn't it?
Oh, God. Anyway, 11-6. And we will be going to number 18 here without a roof on a pretty much full eco. I think this has got a Deagle and a PT-50. That's about it. Pretty much guaranteed round here. Oh, okay. Ape, though, through the mid doors, does find FNX. And I'm going to matter too much. LG already have shown their hand towards the B site. Going to be swarming it as well. Another CT should be dropped here. It's called Zero to find Ape. And now a lot of damage being done through the remaining CT. So that's pretty much GG on this round. Just waiting for this one to finish. Nothing purchased, as I said. Just our boy Buzzer on short. He'll find a kill. But there it is. I knew it every time. We just believe in this guy. He will deliver.
If I just believe it, then I can achieve it. I believe I can fly. Why are we into this singing thing lately?
Karaoke night. That's what we're doing.
I wish, man. I'm so. I would sing Sweet Caroline immediately.
What time is it? 1:20 in the morning. This is when it gets to the drive time show. This is when we actually go off the rails a little bit. Even though we do that all the time anyway. You know. Fallen. Long spawn coming in. The CTs are in a very difficult line here. Famuses, M4s, no kits, little utility, and Luminosity just swarming that long area. As I mentioned before, one of the most lucrative parts of the map in terms of forcing the CTs back, making them react. As long as you have someone like Fur holding the flanks, you can just control the outcome of the round. The CTs need to hit some pretty sick shots here to stop the crossing. They have got no AWP to do it, so flashbangs coming in, smokes as well. How the CTs going to hold this one? Here's the reaction, pushing for those mid doors. As I said, Fur, sick position, listening out for them. Gonna play a conservative approach here. Allow them to get up towards short, then wreck them. The snake in the grass, Matt, as you would say.
Ah, as I would say, you're right. I do like snakes in trousers. Ape, gonna go down to FNX out toward long, and unfortunately it just leaves it to DSR, 1v4.
Well then, I can say about this one. Luminosity, after that second round forced by from without a roof, they just had nothing to work with there. Had Famous's M4, no kits, no utility. It's always a very difficult prospect. And there's a CT's to force in that second and not get anything for it. Especially on a map like Dust 2, you almost 100% need the AWP to actually help control the situations. But 13-6 now, another eco coming in. After a promising first half and finding sixth round, they've got nothing for their money here in the second. Five AKs for Luminosity. Bankroll is getting out of control right now. Maybe rushing B, why not?
Why not?
Cold Zero, spray down, gets the headshot. Now Ape, he's been good at the Deagle. That's why.
As you say it.
Yeah. Just lines them up, knocks them down.
Well, that's pretty pretty, if you know what I mean. Ape gonna try and do it again through the smoke this time. Won't be as fortunate. in his efforts. Not only that, smoke out on the doorway and a Molotov in the window, followed by an additional smoke, makes things extremely difficult for War to get back in toward this B site. FNX going to make it even more problematic as he takes down two, and the pistols, they can chime away all day, but it'll be a merriment tune sung to no one.
Round number 14 achieved for Luminosity here. Comes out to leave. I think they know this one's pretty much over. And I think we do as well. It's going to be round number 21 now. Money has been stabilized. They could go for the double orbs here without a roof, which they have. They were doing it on the T side, so you assume they're going to on the CT. That's where it's more traditional. No one now. He's probably thinking about, yeah, should I just get a third orb as well? But it won't be this time. No orbs for Luminosity, as I said. Just balling out of control right now with the.
Balling out of control.
Yeah. With five AKs and no orbs. Just want to be running around controlling over their spawns and seeing what they can do. Maybe DSR. What's they funny?
I have no idea. Don't mind me. The okay. Korean barbecue bait. Double up setup, flash in. Taco takes down. No one. Taco takes down. Ape. Taco's not done
Goodbye,
yet. Looks
boys.
Toward the door, and finally he'll think, eh, someone else can have some fun. So he'll let Fur walk out from middle. Double face, almost a double spray down.
I've got someone to shoulder. Oh!
Okay, good reactions. Catches the drop down player, but Cold pushes forward. And with the bomb planted, it's all on our boy Buzza.
Dead
now.
Comes
up a little bit silent.
Oh, Buzza.
Buzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Buzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Buzzy Wuzzy wasn't very. Buzzy Wuzzy? Doesn't work, does it?
Double order snipers.
Let's do it.
It's happening. Oh, just one. What?
They had two.
Surely you both
didn't
start.
Buy two. Yeah.
What? Oh, maybe. I don't know.
Are they gun juggling it? They're not gun juggling it. I'm confused.
They just want to end this right now. Then nope. Hit that down. Be respectful.
Oh, you bought it? I bought it too. No, but I bought it first. Okay, fine. Cold Zero doesn't care. He'll go to the AK. He'll get one kill. He might spray down more than that. But nope, he's just going to run by instead because
GG.
He's going to hold off the bomb site. It is going to be GG. Ape and no one, the last two remaining. And it comes to 15-6, make it 16-6, despite that it was 9-6 at the halftime and without a roof. Well, the roof's definitely been lifted off. Come up a little bit quiet in the second half on their CT. The approach from Luminosity considerably better. It's coming back to our ugly faces. Ah, I tried to warn you, but I didn't have time.
Game one is done. Hey.
You're terrible at that.
That's what we do after each game. We ring the bell. I think that's what it's for. Maybe James and Dan do it funnier than us. I think they've got a little feature around this thing. But we're just going to do it after every game. We're going to ring the bell for you guys. There it is. Dust2. Pretty brutal affair in the end. It looked like... without a roof, had a decent chance in the first half. Got six rounds, but didn't get a single round.
Worse like that.
Nice.
Magic.
Bit of entertainment for you there, guys. So what can you say about that one, Matt? We knew it was going to be a 2-0 going into this one.
Yes.
That is a legit thing to say.
All right. I thought
doesn't
you were
have to be a red
me.
Eye quite every time. What can you say? Like, we knew it was going to be a 2-0. They went into this one without their own game leader, who's recently moved to Cloud9. They're missing their best fragger as well in the form of Breeze. It was Buzza who came in.
Buzza did much better on Dust2. I'll give him that. Yeah. He did much, much better on Dust2. And actually, on their T side, was one of their better players, without a doubt.
Absolutely.
One kill in the pistol round that was instrumental. Two kills in the following round, which were big.
Yeah.
One kill in the pistol round, which they did lose, but two kills in the eco round, which was the instrumental kills. Those are massive.
Well, then, that was the first game of the night. We have got one more best of three coming up for you, but any other thoughts on that game you want to point out? Oh, one thing I want to talk about is Luminosity's Dust2. Obviously, it's a go-to veto normally. We never see them play it. I was hoping to see something a little bit more technical, but towards the end of that, they were just having fun. They were just running around. Didn't really have to work too hard, so it's difficult to gauge whether that's actually a map we'll see from them in the future.
I mean, the thing is that it was kind of an unorthodox game to be playing it in because they were up against essentially a pug tonight in the form of War. So if they even wanted to implement strategy, it's kind of hard when you're going against something so loose that you can't really anticipate.
Mm-hmm.
I do hope they bring it back into the map pool. I thought it gave them a little bit more depth, first and foremost. They've obviously strengthened other maps with the roster change, but when you go back to the old Luminosity, it was one of their better maps. And it's kind of a weird thing to think that it is, but it's similar to Na'Vi. It's one of their better maps, even though they're both tactical teams.
Sure.
They both have players that are explosive in Guardian and Flamey and Seized. And it obviously, in Luminosity, is for Cold Zera. FNX at times, he's kind of been wavering lately, but fallen without a doubt on that map. So sure. I think if they can strengthen it up and get it in form for something like the next major, they've got lots of time. They've got 2 months, 2.5 months, essentially.
Okay, especially against this NA region of the ECS, I feel like it's a perfect time for them to kind of get more comfortable on the map and obviously shake off the cobwebs. And like you said, if they can get all seven maps, pretty much Dust2 is the only map they don't play right now, right? So they can get all seven maps there, then they can start playing to their opponent's best maps instead of having to have the go-to Vito every single time being Dust2.
Yeah.
Do you know how much stronger that makes them? Just saying, okay, we can play all the maps and we're just going to veto your best one straight away. And that's like, that. How sick is that, like, going forward? If you have a team that can play all seven. But I don't think that's going to be the case.
I think play one.
Which one's that?
KZ map.
Oh, yeah, that's a good skill to have. The KZ,
they got really
the KZ community hate me. I think I made
someone's
some
got
off-the-cuff comment, and then someone got really mad at me, and all the admins of the websites and stuff started messaging me. I was only joking, guys. I actually don't care for it, but Matt, I know Matt likes it. I was just winding him up.
It's a good place to relax, you know, wind down at the end of a long day.
But I got a lot of haters from that. But anyway.
On that note, we've got time to wind down and relax. 90 minutes until our second best of three. We are going to kick our feet up, probably play some HTC Vive in the studio.
Yep.
Maybe a little bit of Clash Royale. I hate that game. But we'll be back in 90 minutes. I promise it'll be entertaining. We'll see you then.